Thank you. Thank you for joining us on such a wonderful day. I think it was meant to be today. So good afternoon. Welcome. My name is Larry Hook. I'm the superintendent of this wonderful school district. I want to welcome all of our students, staff, community members, and guests to our official groundbreaking ceremony for the new pre-K-12 Carlisle Local School District building. To begin our ceremony, I would ask that everyone please stand and join me in the Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America
and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Great job. Great job. A little over 9 years ago, Carlisle Local Schools began a process of community engagement about what to do with our aging school buildings and what our future would look like. Countless meetings with stakeholders across the district attempting to answer the question of how to address our facility needs and what new facilities might mean or look like in Carlisle. There were many ideas that were discussed and analyzed, but eventually one idea began to emerge as the most logical and most cost-effective solution for our school district and community. Finally, on May 2, 2017, due to the tremendous efforts of so many people throughout the community, many of you sitting here representing all of us, citizens within the Carlisle Local School District spoke with a resounding voice. It is time. It is time to build a new future with a new building that will serve all of our children for generations to come. Since that day, a year and a half ago, an army of community members and professionals have worked untold hours planning to get us to this point in history. Today symbolically marks the beginning of the physical transformation of our school district. Construction fencing will go up next week, and the visible changes will begin to happen before our very eyes. To mark this time, we will now begin our shovel ceremony. As I introduce each of your groups, I'll mention your name. Please come forward and stand up by a shovel. I'll then mention at some point to shovel dirt. Get a shovel full and turn it over. And then you can return to your seat. But remember to smile. Okay, we're going to start this off, first of all, with the Carlisle Local Board of Education, whose vision and dedication for the future of all children within the district is truly amazing. President Tammy Lanehart, Vice President Brian Dunkman, Bill Jewell, Molly McIntosh, and Dale Moore. Grab yourself a shovel. Okay. We can. Okay, walk around the pile of dirt. If you got high heels, you have to walk around. Ready? Shovel dirt. I'm going to have the Board of Education stay right there. Nathan, I'm going to have you join them. This gentleman approaching the pile of dirt is Nathan Jones. He is the Ohio Facilities Construction Committee project manager. The Ohio Facilities Construction Committee is a co-owner in this project, contributing $29 million to this overall budget. So this is truly your owners representing your ownership. And so with that, shovel dirt. Stab your shovel in there. Thank you. You're good. Return. Next up, I want to introduce a representative group of our community and business. This group of individuals is representative of the countless others who have rolled up their sleeves and made this project a reality. This group of members, many belong to the Bond the Village committee that helped pass this bond issue. Many of them are business representatives, and we also have a couple of Hall of Famers in the midst. Ooh. So with that, I'd like to have Courtney Steckel, Jim Gross, Amanda Long, Eddie Crow, Mike Ledford, Allison Couch, Tiffany Burney, Janelle Dobbins, Phil Wilcher, James Rutherford, Bob Chaney. If I missed anybody, hop up there. Okay. Grab a shovel. Yeah. Yep. I don't understand. Snug in a little bit there, Bob. Everybody look back.
Get in there.
Cameras. Shovel dirt. Outstanding. Congratulations. The next group are our professionals that have been working on our project, which includes Mike Parkinson from Steed Hammond and Paul, leading architectural design firm, along with Mike Shoup. Our construction manager, Pete Becker, along with Dave Williams, Lisa Corso, Shane Dennison, Brian Bozeman, Nate Minnick-Weber. Also, it's Katie Kleinfeld. Is she making it? She was on her way. Each of these. Represents an organization that has spent countless hours in preparation for this day, and then a lot of hours yet to come. So with that, I want to thank you so much. Shovel away.
You messed up those good shoes.
You're up, baby. Our next guest is Senator Steve Wilson. Right out in the middle, Senator. I got to tell you, last spring we had some some rules and regulations that got surprised on us out of Washington. And I want you to know that I called Senator Wilson on my way to a softball game and said, we got some issues that we got to really handle legislatively. Steve Wilson and Representative Lips, your senator and your representative, went to work in Columbus and in 6 weeks got a law passed. It benefited this school district, this project, by almost $900,000, and across the state of Ohio, probably close to $1 billion in taxpayer money saved. So thank you, Senator Wilson, for your efforts on our behalf. Shovel up. Next up, I'm going to bring up our village council and Franklin Township trustees, whose combined efforts and voices throughout the community and township have helped influence many voters to support this project. Additional thanks to Village Manager Julie Duffy and her team, along with the Zoning Commission, for their efforts to move our project along through the permitting process. So with that, Village Manager Julie Duffy, Council Members Mayor Randy Winkler, William Bicknell, Tim Humphreys, Nicholas Lamb, Brad McIntosh, Barb Tankersley, Township Administrator Tracy Stivers, Fiscal Officer Scott Frohmeyer, and Trustee Brian Morris. Take a look at her. All right. Shovel dirt.
Come on. You're doing good. I thought I was going to throw it.
Next up, we're all excited. We got a drone going, so look out, science world. All right, next up, we have a representative group from the Warren County Educational Service Center. They have been a partner in education throughout the years of our existence and has made possible to provide the very best education for all of our students. This group, represented by Superintendent Tom Isaacs, Treasurer Alan Eversall, Board President, local resident Jimmy Allen, Spec Ed Director Christy Even, Scott Wilson, and John Beach. Got everybody? There we go. Turn some shovel. Shovel some dirt. Outstanding. Next up is our district leadership team. This is a team of administrators that work diligently on a daily basis to lead our entire school district forward. Their work individually and collectively is invaluable. So I'm going to have Treasurer Dan Bassler, Director of Curriculum Karen McKinley, Director of Special Education Kim Perkins, Principals Mike Milner, Jennifer Deer-Wester, Dan Turner, Brad Potter, Director of Athletics, John Augustine, Director of Food Service, Gail French, Technology Supervisor, Bruce Terry, Transportation and Ground Supervisor, Chad Allen, Building Supervisor, Ken Sprinkles. A larger group, so I'm going to split them in two. This is our instructional leadership team. Our instructional leadership team is comprised of teacher leaders throughout the grade level continuum. It is a larger group, so I'm going to do elementary first. It's a talented group of individuals that work hand in hand with our curriculum director and administrators to provide the best curriculum and instruction support for all of our teachers. So I'm going to have the elementary teachers come up here first. Penny Stewart, Pam Moosey, Aaron Bullock, Amanda Miller, Stacy Lips, Laura Tomko, and Kevin Baker. Give a smile. Shovel dirt. Our secondary leadership team.
Why can't we get on?
Equally as talented. They are Sam Lee, Kelly Crow, Michelle Murphy, Jenny Henry, Katie Schultz, Brian Sprandel, Heather Conger, Courtney Fogle, Deanne Johnson, Erica Sprandel, Susan Cox. Give a smile out to the cameras. Shovel dirt. Good job, guys. Okay, we might need a little help with the youngest ones here. Now, this last group is certainly not the least. In fact, we saved the best for last. These are our K-12 student representatives. They represent all of you and the generations that will follow. Kindergarten student, J.C. Perry. First grade student, Brantley Thecker. Second grade student, Kylie Laughlin. Laughman. Third grade, Braden Higgins. Fourth grade, Ruby Singer. Joseph Feltner. Sixth grade, Thomas Willis. Seventh grade, Kaylin Brown. Eighth grade, Abby Goddard. Abby Goddard. Ninth grade, Derek Sprandel. Tenth grade, Max Allison. Eleventh grade, Jonathan Patla. And 12th grade, Grace Branson. All right, everybody smile for the pictures.
How's Johnson gonna
do this?
Shovel dirt!
Oh, he's doing it!
He's doing it!
Come on!
Today on this day in history. Have a great afternoon. Students can head back.